Hi, I'm Reggie, and welcome to ReTech. In my last video, I provided an introduction to running Docker containers on a Raspberry Pi 4. Today, we'll look at a different way of creating and running containers with a utility called Docker Compose. With Docker Compose, you can create a YAML file, which is just a file format, that can be used to define and to run multiple containers that that define a single application. We're going to start simple and only define a single container, but all of the concepts that we use to do this simple example will still apply to more complex multi-container applications. So I've already installed Docker Compose. So if we take a look at the version running 1.28.6, this is a build that was installed using some instructions. I'll be sure to put a link for what I actually followed if you want to take a look at an easy way of installing it on your own system. And this is also installing that. This is also assuming that you've already installed Docker. And if you followed along with my last video on Docker containers on the Raspberry Pi, you should be good to go by just adding Docker Compose. So I've already created a YAML file, and it's in this directory. So we'll take a look at this, and docker-compose.yml for YAML is the default file name that if you don't specify a file name on the command line, it will look for that specific file. So what we have here, it's pretty straightforward. Under services, we've got PHP, and it uses an image that for PHP that actually is based upon Apache as the web engine. And this is the single, this image is what is actually going to create the single container that we're running. And then we have a couple of resources defined. The first of which is ports, and with this configuration, we basically are telling the operating system and Docker to forward any incoming traffic on port 88 to port 80 inside of the actual container itself. And we're also going to map a single volume, and that's going to be in the current directory where you actually run the Docker Compose command in the PHP www subdirectory. We're going to map that to var www HTML inside of the actual container itself. So that's the YAML file. Again, super simple. You could add more ports to map. You could add more volumes. And there's some things that you can actually do with networking if you're dealing with multiple containers. If that's something that's interesting to people, leave a comment. Let me know that you're interested, and I'll come up with another example that is more complex and contains multiple containers. Most likely, I'll probably just add like a MySQL database or something like that. But if you're interested, leave a comment. Okay, so that is the Docker Compose YAML file. And let's see, if we do a Docker PS, you can see what's currently running. So right now I've been messing around a little bit with Zabbix. If I get any more into it, I'm looking to potentially use it to monitor URLs. Some of my initial investigations have led me to believe that it's probably not the best tool for that. But I may do another video on Zabbix in the future, but it is running in a container as well, but that's the only container that's running. So to get back to our Apache PHP example, now that we've got the file, the configuration file defined, we can run docker compose up, and that should start our container. One thing, because I've run this prior to recording this video, it did not create the container because the container already exists. The first time that you run with Docker Compose, if you do not have a container for the image that you specify inside of the Docker Compose configuration file, it will actually dynamically pull down anything that's missing and use that to create the container. So if we look, I pull up another window. Can do a Docker PS over here. And we see that we are actually running the Apache PHP container, and we actually have our the TCP port 88 mapped into the internal containers port 88. So all the mappings look good. I've also created a file, some files here. As you remember, another one of the other configuration other than the network port mapping was to map a data volume. So this is the data volume. Since we started in the compose directory off of the home directory of py, so compose php www, and I've put a couple of files in here. The first is a super simple HTML file that says it's working. It's actually, let's modify that. And we'll say working for YouTube. We can then take a look and see. So right now we are running on a single interface on that Raspberry Pi. We did not configure HTTPS, so there will be no SSL slash TLS security. It's okay. We're just playing around. So we do that, and we've got our basic HTML. But since we actually included PHP with Apache, if we take a look at this test PHP file, you can run a PHP command, PHP info, basically gives you what the configuration that PHP is running in, as well as the different modules that have been compiled into this running version of PHP. So we can do that by coming up here and specifying specifically test.php, and then we get this output. So these are the different configuration options that were created. Looks like it was built in 2019. It gives you the version of Apache that it's actually running under, and some other options, what the Apache environment is, headers, and let's see, further down, I believe. Okay, yeah. So these are the different functions that and modules that are available within PHP. If you wanted to create an application or a website that was dynamic or something like that, PHP is a great option to start with, but that is pretty much it. Again, Docker Compose, with this Compose file, it does enable you to do some interesting things, especially moving between different systems. So if I wanted to run this on another Linux machine, it doesn't even have to be a Raspberry Pi. I could basically take the Docker Compose configuration file, and as long as I had Docker and Docker Compose installed, I could run Docker Compose up and it just runs. It'll just run on in the new environment with the same configuration. So it's a good way of keeping track of how you're running things, what options that you have set, and makes deploying applications a lot easier. So that's going to do it for this video. If you have any comments or questions, hated this video, love this video, have any questions about Docker Compose or anything Raspberry Pi or Linux, let me know in the comments. If you like this video, give me a thumbs up. And if you're interested in this type of content, go ahead and subscribe, and I'll continue to try to put out interesting content. Thanks a lot for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.